Now we will redo the calculation of Walmart's weighted average cost of capital, but assuming we do not have its beta. Instead, as we learned in the last module, we will use comparable firms to estimate Walmart's beta. The reason we will do this exercise is that many times you do not have the equity beta of the firm you are trying to value. For example, it could be that the firm you are trying to value is not publicly traded. Firms that are not publicly traded do not have information on stock prices and equity returns. This makes it impossible to directly measure their beta. Recall that the beta is measured as the slope of a line of best fit between the firm's returns and the market returns. Another example where you will need this method is when you are trying to value a firm that does not exist yet. Now let's go back to the weighted average cost of capital input table. The only place in which we use Walmart's beta was in the calculation of the cost of equity. We will do this again using a beta estimated from comparable firms. Remember what we did last module to estimate beta from comparables. We followed four steps. The first step is to select comparable firms. Second step is to unlever the beta of comparables to obtain their asset beta. The third step is to average the asset betas of comparable firms. And the last and fourth step is to add the effect of leverage your firm uses to the asset beta. Let's do each of these steps.